So first of all, I'm grateful, especially to Mr. Mardia. I think he rang up, I think, 8-10 times since 2 days back, and he was insisting that I should come. In fact, I was in Baroda. Our minister, power minister, who is also minister of mines, coal, and renewable energy, he was having a officers conference there, and also there is a huge exhibition. So we were busy there, but since they were so insisting, and Mr. Ladda also, he also requested many times, and I thought at least I will join for a roundtable conference, and maybe I can hear what you all have to say during this occasion. I will try to address some of the issues which have been raised just now. As Mr. Ladda has very rightly pointed out, and Mr. Diwan also touched, that government's priority as on date is on Make in India program. In fact, since the new government took over, I think this is one of the very first few initiatives which Prime Minister in fact spelled out very clearly, that we have to substitute imports, we have to give emphasis, wholeheartedly emphasis on import substitution and Make in India. And you also not know that Indian economy is moving very, very fast, and the growth rate, and which has been projected now this year and also for coming few years, it will be 7+ and maybe 8% it can touch this year. So with this growth in economy, obviously infrastructure sector is moving very, very fast. So if you take housing sector, road transport, or railways, all sectors are growing very, very fast. So obviously there will be lot of demand of metals, especially aluminium, copper, zinc, and of course steel is there. So, and that is why keeping this Make in India initiative of Prime Minister in mind, government emphasis is very clear that we have to protect our local industry, not only primary manufacturers but also secondary and other segments of metal industry, and to make country self reliant, we have to work on many front, and first and the foremost is how to build capacity of metal production in India. And in order to increase capacity, we have to increase mining capacity. And I think you may be knowing that currently Ministry of Mines, Government of India, is auctioning various mineral blocks. And we are undergoing a period of reforms. In fact, the whole mining sector is under transformation, great transformation. And it began with the amendment of Mines and Mineral Development and Regulation Act in January 2015, when ordinance was approved, and later on it converted into Act in March 2015 itself. So first and the foremost thing which was introduced, which is the radical change which was introduced, was auctioning of mine, because this is the only, the most transparent and fair method of allotment of mineral leases. So, and perhaps this is the first country, India is the first country where now mining leases are being now auctioned. And you will be happy to know that so far 15 blocks of major minerals have been successfully put on auction. And that And the total resource value of these 15 mines is more than 70,000 crore. And government, state government and the central government would be getting close to 55,000 crore of revenue over the period of mining lease. And these all mining leases are given on 50 years of lease. And we hope that in this financial year, we will successfully auction at least 40 to 50 blocks. So far, 55 blocks were put on auction, NITs were issued, but in many blocks, the response was not good because of many reasons. Either the area was small or exploration was not good to that point. And there were some other problems, but now Karnataka, we have got more than expected good response. And there are about another 15 mines from Karnataka, that is of iron ore, that those all mines would be put on auction. And other than auctioning, the very major change which has been introduced is, by the government is that we have notified National Mineral Exploration Policy, and we are going to facilitate private sector participation in exploration. Because so far the exploration was purely in the domain of government, Geological Survey of India, and to some limited extent Mineral Exploration Corporation of India were engaged in regional exploration. And but now government want to bring private sector in a very big way in exploration. And in the meanwhile, we have identified 100 big blocks of 100 square kilometer each. Out of these 100, there are surfacial minerals like iron ore, limestone. There are blocks of copper, bauxite. And also, there are about 70 blocks of gold and diamond. These are deep-seated minerals where we want to invite private sector for participation. We are working out a revenue sharing formula so that the explorer can also be benefited if there is a discovery of resources. And apart from these 100 blocks, we are engaging global level exploration company. We are going to do aerogeophysical survey of obvious geological potential area of India. We have nearly 32 lakh square kilometer of area. Out of this 32, 8 lakh square kilometer area is OGP area, that is obvious geological potential area, where are strong evidences of availability of resources in that landmass. So now what we are going to do is in next 2.5 to 3 years time, we are going to complete aerogeophysical survey of this 8 lakh square kilometer of area with 300 meter of line spacing. And once we complete it, then we will be at par with Australia, Canada, South Africa, and we hope that huge resources, untapped resources, would be discovered once we complete this aerogeophysical survey of 8 lakh square kilometer of area. So these are the some of the initiatives which government has taken in very recent past as far as mining and exploration is concerned. Now coming to this protection, obviously government has to protect various segments of these metal industry, whether it is aluminium, copper, or lead or zinc. But and there are various protection measures by way of tariff barriers, maybe it is an import duty or MIP as we have introduced in steel, or safeguard duty as aluminium, primary aluminium industry, they have also moved for a safeguard duty. But what government desires is to build a consensus among the various segments of primary metal industry. Like for example, aluminium, we have recycling industry, scrap, we have secondary aluminium producers, we have EMA, that is electric and electronics manufacturers, then we have cable and conductor manufacturers, then we have utensil manufacturers, and then of course we have primary aluminium manufacturer associations. So there are many stakeholders within the aluminium industry. So what government want is that there should be broad consensus on whatever the measures we want to propose for primary metal industry. Because why I'm say primary metal industry? Because they are directly affected by LME prices. World over, there has been the fall of commodity prices. Commodity prices have fallen very, very sharply. And also, at the same time, there was impact of China, slowdown of China economy. So because of these two reasons, and of course, it is a cyclic phenomena, LME prices of copper as well as aluminium have fallen sharply, as has been pointed out by my earlier speaker. So keeping this in view, we have to protect not only, of course, we have to protect primary manufacturers, but at the same time, we want to have consensus among all the stakeholders of aluminium industry. So we are working out some consensus formula. We had four or five discussions in recent past because all these segments, they have their own demands, they have their own challenges, they have their own requirements. So keeping that in mind, we are working out, and hopefully we will go for increase in import duty of not only of primary aluminium but also for secondary industry also. As far as this copper is concerned, no doubt there has been surge in import from Japan, Asian countries, UAE, and also from Russia. And copper industry, they have also moved for safeguard duty. And as Ministry of Mines will certainly support safeguard duty if there is a case, and hopefully they are representing before safeguard commissioner. And we are concerned with this fact that both Hindustan Copper Limited, Hindalco, and Birla Sterlite, they have been affected badly because of LME prices. And I think currently LME prices are at the rock bottom of about 4,600 or so. And although there was a demand from to reduce this duty, to scrap duty of 2.5% to make it 0% on copper concentrate, because that is the raw material being imported by certain manufacturers. So we support this, and we have already recommended to Revenue Ministry to reduce this duty on copper concentrate from 2.5 to 0%. And we also support their demand for export, what is that? Yeah, export incentive of 2%, and we have already recommended that certainly in time to come we will support whatever the measures of copper primary copper manufacturers have proposed, whether it is safeguard duty or reduction of export duty on copper concentrate or on export incentive. So this is about copper. As far as lead or zinc is concerned, I am not aware whether they have any serious problem. Mainly it is the Hindustan Zinc Limited, and prices have also, LME prices have also firmed up recently. This is about aluminium as well as copper. So broadly what I want to say is that we are increasing the capacity, we are building the capacity of production of not only primary metals but also downstream industry, number one. Number two, we want to protect this industry, and whatever the measures which are required to protect domestic industry, government is very serious to take those initiatives, and Ministry of Mines support this. And the third thing is to put these protective measures, we want to have consensus among different stakeholders within the primary metal industry. So I think hopefully situation will increase. Though there is no hope for immediate future of recovery of metal prices, what I am hearing from primary manufacturer, but still if demand increases, if there is an increase in production, certainly there will be relief to our industry. So once again, I thank organizers of this conference. And if you have any other point, if you want to meet me separately, if you want to raise some more issues about some specific segment or subsector of primary metal, then you are most welcome. So thank you very much once again.